here are my two panels. This is going to be the top and this is going to be the bottom, and I've got them marked in the orientation in which they're going to end up in my piece. So this one is going to be on top of this one. And so I have changed my design a little bit. I laid some things out. I think I'm going to clip these corners off at about 15 degrees. And so I've got it marked here with this pencil. I've got both of the, an edge joined on each one of these panels, and that's all I'm going to, that's all I need to do right now. But I'm going to take this and I'm going to cut this at 15 degrees and at the other end at 15 degrees. Just, you know, waste some of this, you know, crack away on the end of the, on the end of these boards. And, but I'm only going to do this on one board. I mean, on one panel. So I'm going to cut these both to both ends at 15 degrees, and I'm going to use my, you know, I'm going to use my, one of my favorite machines back there at the end there, that the multifunction table with the cross cut and the T55 Festool saw. I can make really, really accurate cuts, but I'm only going to do it to one board here. I'm going to cut the 15 degrees on both ends of these, and then I'm going to cut my arc. And once I get that arc cut, then I'm going to take this board and I'm going to set it on top of this one and clamp it. And I'm going to use the my big router, and I'm going to template route. So both panels are identical. I mean, it's going to be, so if I have a little bit of variation when I flip the board or the arc is a little bit off, so each one will be, you know, if I keep this orientation and I put this one on top of the other one to template route it, they will be identical mirror images of one another, even if there is a little bit of variation that you'd never notice. So that's the key thing, is that's why I have them marked both up. I have the joined edge back here, so after this gets cut and the arc gets cut, I'll put this one on top of this and I'll use it to template route. So let me go back and cut these ends off on the Festool multifunction table. Well, I'm set up to make my cut now, and I'm going to cut that at 15 degrees. I'm just going to show you this overview, and then I'll put it up higher for you to see. But there's my multifunction table, and then mine sits up on a little platform because it was too low for me. So it's the same height as my work table, and then, of course, it's the same height as my portable vacuum station that my Festool vacuum fits in. And so, since I'm tricking the vacuum into thinking that, well, I've got this duplex switch here, but I can turn the vacuum on by this switch, just by this light tricking the switch into thinking that it's a tool, or I can trigger the vacuum here. So it's a pretty convenient thing to do, to set your vacuum in here. And then the vacuum was always just a pain because it had the linear casters and the rolling casters, and so I could never get it to roll right around my shop. So this always, you know, this has all my sanding stuff and you know, my vacuum tools, plus it's an outfeed table. It's exactly the same height as everything else in my shop, and so I can just wheel it around for whatever I need to use it for. And it's a little multifunction table on the top. So it's a great setup. All right, this multifunction table, I don't use this every day, but when I need it really badly. So this will keep you from having to buy a panel saw. And this thing is just the greatest. So I've got it set at 15 degrees. That's what I'm gonna cut my ends at. That's what I think is gonna look nice. I kind of laid it out with colored marker a few times, but let me just make sure my depth is right. So I've got the vacuum plugged in, the tool trigger's on, and then, see these clever Festool clamps, they'll just pin my workpiece up against here so it can't shift on me, especially cutting on an angle. And the real beauty of this saw is that when you put your fence down, your guide, the saw cuts exactly where the rubber guide is. Now I want to cut a little bit off of this. I've got some planer snipe. I'll cut about that much off. So I'm all set here. That's all there is to it. And you can see here, this is my, this is my multifunction table sitting up on my little platform. And so the second I'm done with this, my saw goes right back into the place where it belongs. It goes into the sustainer that I put here on these safe and out of the way, clean, it doesn't get dusty. And it's just ready for me at a moment's notice when I need to use it again. This one's for my router. This is where I keep my router, in that big sustainer here. And I have all kinds of accessories and what have you back behind here. And then this full extension drawer is kind of a mess right now, but it's got all Festool stuff in it too, multifunction jig, my router guide. But even though it's pretty haphazard in here, it's pretty safe because nothing would ever get piled on top of it.